All right, everybody. I want to talk to you about five principles of a good motorcycle rider. This is very important because I talk about principles all the time, the smart rider principles, but I'm going to go ahead and explain just a few things a little bit more in depth while I'm waiting for this train to move on. I'm actually going to move off to the side to give myself a good space cushion between everybody and double checking the guy behind me is going to stop. All right, so while I'm here, I guess I can go ahead and talk to you about this. First one is my set of principles, riding smart. You're going to seek out and recognize hazardous situations, maintain fundamental skills, acquire personal protective equipment, rescue other riders with medical training, and then teach and mentor other riders. That is the smart rider principle. So you're going to ride smart, okay? So you're going to be searching out for different situations, which we talk about all the time on this channel and the main channel, Dan and the Fireman, when I go over after action reviews to really show you why you need to be paying attention. Same thing with fundamental skills. You're going to go out and practice. You're going to go find a parking lot. You're going to practice while you're riding so you can be efficient with your practicing, so you can swerve while you're riding, you know, around manhole covers and everything. You can go out and do some parking lot exercises like we have on this channel. But you're going to maintain those fundamental skills. You're going to get gear, okay? It's pretty easy. Acquire it, but then you got to utilize it. Make sure you wear it every single time you go out for a ride. Also, if you want to rescue other riders with medical training, I got my med kit back here in my saddle bag just in case I see another car crash or I see another motorcycle rider crash and any of these things. That way I can save them if I have to. And I'm teaching, mentoring you. And that allows me to know what I'm talking about so that when I go riding and I talk to you guys, I am boned up on what I need to know. So that's the whole point of teaching and mentoring. So that is very important. So follow those principles. And we're going to talk about some other ones that I think that will exemplify some of the things that you really need to focus on too. All right. So it looks like the train is gone. That's pretty nice. So one of the things that you need to do is understand the risks. Okay. So being situationally aware, all those things about smart rider principles, it's fine and dandy, but you also need to understand that motorcycling is inherently dangerous. That way you need to actually become a smart rider. You need to practice and do all those things. Okay. There's a why you need to be a smart rider. And that's because riding a motorcycle is risky. It's a lot more risky than some other things, okay? So be very aware of that. Understand that since it is risky, that you're gonna go ahead and get that training, you're gonna get that gear, and you're gonna be situationally aware. And that's the thing, when you understand it, you need to accept those risks, okay? So accept the fact that motorcycling is way more dangerous, multiplied by crazy amounts of numbers compared to a car. I don't remember exactly, but it's extremely, extremely dangerous compared to that. So if you accept those risks, don't just say, well, I accept it, okay, end of story. No, you accept it, and then you definitely get that training. You definitely pay attention to those things, and you say hi to people out on the road. What's up, guys? How you doing? And you go out and get that training, okay? It's not just about, hey, you know, I'm gonna go ahead and ride around. No, you accept it, you understand it, and you will not let the thrill of your adrenaline. You're not gonna be like, oh, I'm just gonna say screw it and, you know, get complacent and say, I'm gonna go ahead and ride like crazy, screw it. No, you understand it, you accept it, therefore you will follow the set of principles you have set forth for you, which is the smart rider principles. You do not let ego, you do not let your adrenaline dictate how you are going to ride. That is not what you should be doing, because that will increase your risks and you don't want to do that. Now, we talked about the smart rider principles and the A portion of acquiring and utilizing it, and that's fine. It's pretty simple, right? Well, what is it that you need to wear? What is it you need to do? I do have a video on that of what not to wear, and I do give you some resources on what you should wear. You might want to check that video out, but the next thing is you need to wear protection, okay? I'm double emphasizing this one. You need to wear protection, okay? So we understand the risks, we're accepting them, and then we know that if we do crash, we could get severely injured or die from them, and the only way to really minimize that after the crash happens, right? To minimize that and mitigate that is to wear protective gear, okay? So the severity of a crash, let's say it's a 10 out of 10, and that's a possibility of dying, if not dead. If you wear gear, maybe it knocks it down to an 8 out of 10 where you do survive and you do not have long-lasting injuries. So I would rather have a crash that has gear on so that I, you know, still have to go to the hospital, I still have to do all these things, maybe a broken bone, but it heals in 8 to 12 weeks, maybe a little bit of rehab, compared to just being dead or having a brain injury that affects me for the rest of my life and I cannot, you know, think or do a bunch of different things that I was able to do prior to the accident. So I understand the risks, I'm accepting them, and now I'm gonna use a solution, which is to wear gear, because you need to, okay? You absolutely need to. All right, so let's move on to the next thing, is you're willing to help new riders. Now, I talked about that in the Smart Rider Principles, teaching and mentoring other riders. Now, in order for me to get better and better and better and better, I have to figure out ways to teach. And while I'm trying to figure out ways to teach, I get better and better and better. But it allows me to now share with you guys what it is I learned, and I have to make it in a way that you understand. Therefore, I understand it 12 different ways. And I absolutely love that. It made me a better rider. It made me a more safety conscious rider. It made me understand the white, yellow, orange, red, and brown stage. I'm in orange stage, but I can have one hand off. I don't recommend you guys do it, but I can still see everything. I'm able to do all these different things, and I have the nuance of understanding how to do it, what to do it, how you do it, so I could do it that way, because I know you're gonna do it anyways. But how do I teach you so that you could do how you do it? That way I could just show you, because I know a lot of you guys ride without a hand, and I could show you how to ride. See, you see how it goes on and on and on? If you can do that for somebody else, you are going to have way more knowledge than if you just took classes. Becoming a teacher, becoming a father, becoming a coach, becoming an instructor, all these different things that I have done has allowed me to become better as a person. And that is what I want you to do. I want you to go out there and try to teach somebody new. I want you to be understanding of somebody new. And then you're going to be able to gain more knowledge because you realize there's different problems for different people. So you find the solutions for different people and different problems, and you know what you're doing. Okay, that's the whole point of the teaching and mentoring, and I would love to be able to share more of that, but I think we're going off on a tangent here, and I just wanted to talk to you about the five principles of a good motorcycle rider, okay? With that said, I hope you guys check out the other videos on this channel and subscribe. I'll be seeing you around.